Hello everybody, TA Drag Racer here. We're at the Autodromo Jose Carlos Pace Raceway in Brazil. Also Interlagos is what it used to be called. Racing the F3s. I've been on this track once in a GT3 cars. Quite a bit different than the F3. So let's see how we do. I qualified 17th out of 20... I think there's about 23 people. It's a big race. Let's see how we can do. Hope you enjoy the race. Be a standing start. I'm not going to do that. I haven't even set up the dual clutch in this car. So I'm just going to take off normal. I've got 16 other drivers in front of me anyway and a bunch behind me. So I don't want to cause a bunch of havoc. My hope is just to get around, finish the race, and do okay. I'm definitely not at the top pace, but I'm not at the bottom pace, so let's see how we do. Racing 18 laps, and here we go.
Green flag, green flag, green flag. Left side. Clear if you need it. Left side. Clear. Left side. Still there. Front
end,
front end, front end. Up, one off
court,
one off
court. It's chaos in this first lap. I don't think people even practiced. I've only practiced today. At least able to get around, hopefully, the first lap. We'll see. Cars are a lot of fun to drive. I can't handle the F1 cars yet. I'm trying to work my way up to them eventually. There's somebody spun on behind me. Track was a lot of fun, sarcastic, to learn driving the GT3 cars, but I finally kind of got it down. That's what was nice about running a series. You race a lot of tracks, you weren't normally going to just pick the race. I was going to race the whole season, B-Class, GT3, VRS, but towards the end I was my safety rating and my eye rating and taking such a plunge from not knowing many of the tracks, being outclassed by a lot of the drivers. I decided just to race out the end of the season.
Watch your car down there. Stay right.
Get prepared for promotions, get my A license, which I've done. Now I'm kind of picking and choosing races I'm going to put to race. Kind of fun. Tell you, thanks to Dave Cam, listening to him, I got the Heusenfeld Ultimate Plus pedal system, and man, it's made a huge difference in my racing. I'm so much more confident. I'm not going to lock up the brakes every time I touch them. Wear shoes. Better than my wearing socks, but it's nice. It's just nice there. They're great pedals, but they're very, very expensive. But I decided to go for them. I'm glad I did. A little more confident going into corners. I can control the brake almost where I want it. Not always, but most of the time. So easily adjustable with the software. It's a great purchase. Anybody that can afford it or swing it, it's definitely a worthwhile purchase. Getting a really good set of pedals. Thanks, Dave Cam, for helping me spend $1,300.
Clear.
accurate it is, but the countryside is really pretty. It's nice to see the sun. Look down Brazil. It's like going into their fall now. Starting to see more sun around here, warming up a little bit. It gets colder again, warms up. Shouldn't be too far around the corner though. Get a chance, you'll try to drive one of these cars. They're a lot of fun. Handle really well. I guess I'm gonna get up and go in them.
Clear if you need it.
That was a good move. Quit hitting the rev limiter, I know that. Blow this little engine all up. Well, that's what the rev limiter is for. A drag car, I can just sit there and hold it to the floor. MSD system in it. Control the RPM wherever I have it set. Launch from the drag strip. I had it set to about 5,000 RPM, I think. Launch pretty hard. It's got 16-inch wide slicks in the back. 800 horsepower big block Chevy in it. Let's giddy up and go. To qualify for my license, then I had to take just a short face click, come out of the hole and coast for the first launch. I did that, front wheels come up about a foot off the ground. They come back down, I'd had the steering wheel cocked a little bit, jerked a little bit. I let off of, which is what I was supposed to do anyway. I drove it back to the trailer, got off, sit on the trailer for a minute, thought to myself, do I want to do this or not? I hadn't driven anything that fast. The Trans Am that I used to drag race prior to that, it was nowhere near that quick. Big difference. It was also a lot of fun. And it's weird, once you get used to it a little bit, you don't even really notice those things. The first few launches, I definitely noticed it. Where the server is at for this race. Most of the people are from either Europe or possibly down South America. My ping time is 133, which is pretty high for me, usually it's around 50. 33 to 66, somewhere in that range. It's a big international race. Where else could I race him? Whoa. He went off and I went off. Split around. Go off. A couple incident points though. I didn't do any studying for this race to see what the preferred line and shift points are for the curves and all that. So I'm definitely not running max performance. I've been caught a few times. Decided to have some fun with this. Last day for week one, season two. I've been racing a lot on the Nordschleife and the Lotus 49. It's been, geez, I haven't got through the whole daggone race without cracking up into something. But I'm addicted to the Nordschleife. Get a video out of whatever my best race was. I've raced through the bunch. But almost every time we've got my rating increases and safety increases, so it's not all bad. Start of the week, I got my safety down the hole, down the low ones. Right now I'm 1-6 in this race. We'll see what I get up to by the end of the day. I'm gonna just do a couple more races. Probably on the Nordschleife. I do pretty good on there. Good safety bump. I just got quit hitting things. Nobody's wrecking me per se. I'm just running off the track. That thing's a bear to drive, but it's a lot of fun. It's a 1960s F1 car. Little Cosworth engine in it. Five speed gearbox. Feel like much suspension at all. You feel every little bump fly off the track all the time. It's a heck of a lot of fun.
Everybody's running about the same speed ahead of you.
Geez, I listened to him. I don't know. Threw me off for some reason. But what the hell? I better slow down if they're all running the same speed. Damn. I don't know what happened there. Gotta stay awake. I only got 2 laps left. Look at the pin entrance, I drive halfway to it, about every lap.
Left side, clear. White flag.
Yeah. Well, I gotta stay awake for this last lap. Best I can. Take a look, see what the results are. I got a 0.24 increase in safety rating, 16 I rating increase. I think I finished 11th. Let's see what the official results say. Yep, 11th. Overall, not bad. 23 people in the race, qualified 17th. I'm happy. If you enjoyed the race, I'd appreciate you leaving a like. Consider subscribing. It's TA Drag Racer signing out.